Hey, this is Presh Talwalkar.
AI has become so powerful, it feels like it can do anything, from writing summaries, to composing poems, to producing images from text. But while AI models depend on mathematical calculations to produce results, the AIs themselves are ironically not very good at solving math problems in general. But all of that could change very soon. Google has announced a breakthrough in new models that can solve extraordinarily challenging questions from a contest known as the International Mathematical Olympiad, or IMO for short. The IMO is an annual contest for pre-college students that started with 7 countries in 1959. Today it has expanded to over 100 countries, sending teams of 6 students each. On each of 2 days, students solve 3 questions in 4.5 hours. Each question is worth 7 points, so out of a possible 42 total points, the average mean score is about 16. So even these students find these questions to be tough, and that makes them a great test for AI's math ability. Google's AI models scored a remarkable 28 points by solving 4 of 6 questions, a score equivalent to winning a silver medal. Congratulations! AlphaProof tackled 2 algebra and 1 number theory problem, while AlphaGeometry tackled the geometry question. And some of the performance was scarily good. Students have an average of 1.5 hours to solve each question. Google's AlphaGeometry solved the geometry question in a mere 19 seconds. Wow! So are computers ready to replace mathematicians? Not so fast. The results need to be given proper perspective. The result is not exactly an apple-to-apple, or shall we say, a Google-to-Google comparison. For one, the time limits were not the same. Students had to solve 3 questions each day in 4.5 hours. Google's model was allowed to have 3 days to work out one of the problems. So given the extra time, you would think that some of the students would have solved some of the extra problems as well. The other issue is exactly how the models solved the questions. Students had to read, interpret, and then solve the question within the time limit. But the AI model was given a head start. Google's models were trained on past Olympiads and similar questions. That's fine, students can prepare like this as well. How did that work? The Gemini AI would take regular questions written in plain language and translate them into a formal language called Lean. Lean is a proof assistant, and these proofs have the advantage that they can be verified for correctness. Right now, the translation part is not great for the models, so they might mistranslate the question. But that's fine because the models can then train from these mistranslated problems and still keep learning. But they didn't want the model to have the wrong question on this IMO. So what did they do? The models were not translating the questions. It was actually humans who manually translated the questions into formal code. So this is what it might look like. So let's take question 4, which is a geometry question on the test with the following text. You're not given a diagram on the text. Now, if you want to know how a human would approach and solve this question, you can check out my video on this very question. It's a very challenging question. I wouldn't have been able to solve it, but it's very interesting. So the first step a human would take is to interpret the words and make a sketch. And this isn't a simple task. You know, sometimes you're reading a question and you make a sketch and you realize your sketch is bad and you have to start all over. But the AI didn't have to start from scratch like that. Humans took the time to understand the question and then translate it into the formal language Lean. So Google released the code and it looks exactly like this. Now, I don't know anything about Lean, but even without knowing any technical details, you can make a guess about what the code means. The first thing the code does is define a triangle with 3 vertices, A, B, and C. Then the 3 sides are given to be different lengths. The point I is then the in-center of A, B, and C, and other conditions are presented like points X, B, and C are collinear, but the point X is not equal to C. So other conditions are then given like which points fall on a line, which lines are perpendicular, and so on. So I would say it's not a simple task just to translate the text into the language, and there's a risk that you could mistranslate the question. How would you know if you accidentally slipped an assumption and put that into code? In any case, assuming the translation is done correctly, the model then proposes possible proofs and checks whether they are true or not. So they're not giving details about how the model does this step, but I'm just guessing something along the lines about trying to figure out directions from a starting point to an ending point, or maybe starting at the ending point, which is the conclusion, and working in reverse. This is just a total guess because they released the proof as a reverse proof, where you start out with the conclusion and then you work backward with all valid statements to the original assumptions that were there. Now, this year's question 4 would be solved by many humans by extending these two lines. But just as the AI might come up with some very unusual directions when you're on GPS, this AI came up with an entirely novel solution of constructing another point. It's said to extend BI until the point E in such a way that BEA is a right angle. What this does is you can construct a circle between these three points, and then that would make the midpoint of the line AB as the center of the circle. So it actually gives an interesting technique. From there, you can construct a bunch of similar triangles, and eventually you'll be able to get to the conclusion that you want. So it's kind of interesting that the AI was able to come up with a proof that maybe a regular human wouldn't have thought about. Whether it's a better proof or not will be up to the details, but it's still interesting it came up with a new construction. So in conclusion, we can say it's not fair to say that Google's AI earned a silver medal, as it was given extra time and a translation of the question. It didn't face the same difficulties of the students who were actually taking the test, who had to interpret the question and solve it within the time limits. But even then, it is an incredible achievement that it could solve 4 of the 6 problems. I can speak for the majority of us by saying I'd never be able to solve any of these questions even with unlimited time. So if there was a tool that could help me understand the ideas and then learn the proofs, that would be excellent. So congratulations to Google DeepMind for coming up with a tool that can solve Olympiad level questions. I'm looking forward to, just as we use calculators for doing intricate calculations, we soon may be using computers to assist with mathematical proofs. And anything that makes my life easier is something I'm looking forward to. What times we're living in. Thanks for making us one of the best communities on YouTube. See you next episode of Mind Your Decisions, where we solve the world's problems, one video at a time.